my book is honest. It tells you, it goes way behind the scenes that no one has ever really written about because of this. Here's why I want to say that. Nobody that has written any books on wrestling, nobody that's written any books on WWE, had the relationship for as close and as long as my relationship has been with Vince McMahon.
Yeah.
I was in a very unique place. I was either his number one or number two guy, either me or Kevin Dunn, depending on who you talk to. And I love that arrangement, but it's a lot of pressure, and we all have to guard. The one thing about wrestling is you guard your territory, literally. And so that was, and sometimes in an unhealthy manner. So I think people are going to love this book. I really do. And I'm not patting. Monsoon would say, "Don't break your arm patting yourself on the back." But it's one of the best things. I'm proud of it. And I had read the audio book, which was the hardest thing I've done thus far in my broadcasting career, because every moment of every line in that book I could relate to because I lived it. I lived it. And I was honest enough. You think I would get on my book and say, "Hey, you know, I had a little opiate problem back in the day nobody knew about. You know, I was taking Ambien like they were Chiclets."
Man.
I was taking, the Ambien didn't get me where I needed to go at night. Most of us have done it at night so I could sleep. I would take a Xanax. And then sometimes, being the egomaniac that I was and being quote-unquote bulletproof, I'd chase all that with Crown Royal. So it's a recipe for disaster. I'm smarter than that. But I didn't have the strength to back off, and I didn't have the courage to raise my hand and say, "I need a little help here." And then so finally I got so sick with my stomach aches. That's when I left WWE and came to Oklahoma. And then they realized I was about 30 days away from dying because of my large intestine had perforated.
Oh, my God.
And I was poisoning myself. So it was a really interesting time in my life that I think people can relate to, Nick. Now, maybe not the colon thing or whatever, but the challenges. My God, we're in the midst of the biggest challenge in the history of our country right now.
Yeah.
With this coronavirus.